60 here. Cold Wednesday morning. I just dropped my mom off at the bank there. She should be coming out in a minute. I just thought I would come on here and say hi and hope everyone is well. We've had a couple of sad days there, but we're doing okay. A friend of mine had passed away yesterday. It was pretty hard to take. Her funeral's on Saturday, so we'll be going to that. Well, I'll be going. And a bunch of us from work. Anyway, Mom's coming in, so I will see you in a bit. Go to work. I only fill in now when people are sick or anything. I don't bother. I don't like to go to work full time anymore. It's just too much. My son's coming. I'll be right back.
Alrighty.
I'm back and off. And here we go. Here we go. Mom usually comes with me when I go to work, but she didn't feel like it today. So that's good. It's been a crazy few days. I've had enormous disagreements with people. Yeah, so I'm headed off to fill in for somebody today. Which I like. Kind of gives me a little bit of a break from Mom. Tomorrow my daughter's going in for surgery. And thank God it's at the hospital she works at, so that's a good thing. We have to be there for noon. I believe her surgery is at 2, and then I have to be there for a little bit for her for after post-op stuff. So itchy. That's unusual. Usually they only, when they're doing construction work across the roads here, I don't know what it's like anywhere else, but in our city, they always have one patrol car, one police car available, and they've got 3 there. That's really odd. Really odd. So it's a beautiful sunny day. It's cold. Those menacing clouds up there definitely look like snow clouds. It's probably cold enough to have snow. I'm not looking forward to it. I gotta bring my car in. I gotta phone them today. I'll phone them when I get home, see if I can bring the car in on Friday to get, you know. I don't need an oil change till November, so that's a good thing. So, so we're still looking for an apartment. There's nothing available. There's nothing available, right now. I'm not fussy on moving, December or January. Or February or March. Trouble is, the rents are usually cheaper. You can usually find apartments where they have like 1 month free or some kind of deal. Right now there's no deals. So, and if we wait till the spring, the rents tend to go up a little bit in the spring, you know, maybe $50 a month, but $50 a month over a year is quite a bit. So, anyway, so we're still looking and looking. We shall see what happens. haven't been able to get into my craft stuff. We've been dealing with my son's issues. Stuff like that. I don't know if I'm going to make this 7. Yes, I am. I'm going to make the light. I'm going to make it. Yes, thank you. It'd be nice to get to work a little early for a change instead of always being late. Well, I'm not really late, per se. Usually I'm there 5 minutes beforehand. Got my glasses? Oh, they're there. Oof. Although I have a spare in the little container here. Sorry, guys. Let me think. I have not been in the mood to do crafts. I wanted to do a couple of DIYs, and I just can't get in the mood. I just can't seem to motivate myself to do anything. I think it's, I don't know what it is. Just can't seem to get into it. I loved it when I had my craft area and I could just go and do it whenever I felt like it. You know, go into my room and do it. I'm really, really looking forward to that, having my own space. I mean, I don't mind sleeping in the living room, but we've got so many boxes packed that there's just no place to put a table, or even if I did it on the dining room table, my crafts are all in boxes, and all my craft supply stuff. I know I'm whining. Sorry about that. I hope everybody is doing well. I hope that everyone is staying safe. I know you guys have a big election coming up. That is very emotional and very difficult for you guys this time. This election, I think, has really exhausted a lot of people. Fortunately, it's been quite a while since we've had exhausting elections where you're fed up with the candidates, you don't know what to do, you know. So my heart goes out to all of you. Just go vote. That's the biggie. You can't bitch and complain about things going on if you don't vote, because then your voice is not heard, right? That's something that I've been very, very adamant about, is if you didn't vote, don't bitch at me if you don't like what's going on in government. I mean, that's stupid. That's like saying, you know, well, I'm not going to go to school, but then you bitch because you can't get a job because you haven't got an education. You know, it's the same thing. So, go out and vote, guys. Go out and vote. I know it's a toughie, and I know some of you feel very strongly about your particular candidate. From an outsider to you guys, all I'm saying is, as a citizen of the world, as a citizen of your country, it's your duty to vote. It's your duty. Otherwise, you should not complain. You know, I hear people, I know, sorry, I'm getting political here. I don't mean to, but I hear people complaining and bitching about stuff. Well, I'm not going to vote because they're both idiots, or I'm not going to vote. And I don't mean Americans, I mean Canadians too. Oh, I'm not going to vote. I don't like what they stand for. I don't trust government. I don't, you know. Well, you know what? If you don't vote, you have no rights. None to bitch, because you haven't used your constitutional right to vote so that you can bitch. In other words, you haven't paid your dues. Oh, I'm sorry. It's just the way I feel. You know, I remember one election year here in Canada many years ago. There was people bitching and complaining about the government and how they don't trust them and how blah, blah, blah. Well, you know, I don't know how the system works in the States, but here in Canada, you vote for the person you believe in, and basically it's the party, but you know, if you're voting for someone, basically it is the party, but make sure that the person who is running in your riding is the person that you believe will make a difference for you. Anyway, that's my bitching talk for today. Okay, guys, I'm at work. I know I shouldn't say a word. But that's just my own personal, as a citizen of your country, vote. Otherwise, you know, that the whole idea about voting is that it gives you license to bitch and complain about the government. And if you don't vote, keep your mouth shut, because you did not do it. Sorry. I'm at work, and all that time I was babbling on and on and on about businesses. Well, it is my business in that I love you guys very much, and I hope that everything turns out the way you want it to. But as a Canadian citizen, from my own voting experience, if you don't vote, you don't bitch. Oh my God. And I know, listen guys, I know we have the same problems everywhere in the world. If you have someone that you don't trust that's in government, or you don't trust the government anymore, you don't know what to do, but you still, you need to at least find a candidate, support a candidate, someone who will, you know, act on your behalf. It's always from the ground up, right, guys? All right. I have to get ready to go in. I'm here. I love you guys. I wish you all the best in the next couple of weeks. I know it gives you a headache. I know it gives me a headache. Oh, where did this come from? Oh, cool. I have a pen here I didn't even know I had. Okay, here's my paperclip. All right, guys. Gonna let you go, and we'll see you soon. Bye for now. It was a good day. Everybody was asking me where I was. Aren't you working anymore? There. When we first get to work, when I'm selling cards for the charity at the bingo, we have to count our cards, and we mark them on a sheet and count how many we have, and then they give us a float. You have to keep track of that. So every time we sell, motorcycle, you know, we can keep track of our money, make sure we're not short and whatever. I was short $2, but that's, we have toonies instead of loonies, guys. You know that, guys. Anyway, I was selling a card to a girl, and she gave me her toonie, and it went flipping, flying, and I don't know where it landed. We looked all over, so I thought it landed in my pocket. But so if I'm short of money, I always put it in from my own pocket, because you know we don't want the charity to be short. Anyway, yeah. So after we're finished selling cards and bingo's over, then we go around and clean all the tables and straighten out the chairs and everything else and get all that, getting it ready for the next bingo. So just finished that. Now I'm going to pick up Mom. Mom wanted to go to the 4 o'clock game, so I am going to go and pick her up. It's gotten awful gray. Remember I was talking about those clouds? They look like snow clouds. Well, it's kind of gray. Kind of yucky. I just got a phone call just a little while ago from the apartment we went to see. I left her my name in case something came up. She knows I only want an end unit. It's on the second floor, which would be awesome for me, because I don't like going up high. mom would like to go and see it. I can't go tomorrow. My daughter's having surgery, so I'll be gone all day. Maybe Friday. So we'll go and see it. I haven't given my 2 months notice yet, so we really cannot afford to move in on the 1st of December, because that means even though my last month's rent would pay for December, I still need last month's rent for the other place. Usually what we do is at the end of our lease, when we give our 2 months notice, the month that we usually, our last month's rent was paid when we moved in. So that month would have been paid, and then the money you usually give to your last month's rent would go towards the last month of the next place. So you're always, you know, it's always ahead. But I don't know if you guys do the same thing there in the States. I'm not sure how your rentals work there. Excuse me, I gotta go pick up mommy. Alrighty, let's go in the other lane, because a lot of these people turn to the right. So I like to go to the left. Yeah, anyway, so thank God the bingo's only about 7 to 10 minutes away from home, except when there's traffic. So we're going to be running a little late, but that's okay. That means we don't sit around. A couple of years ago, oh my God, Mom used to drive to bingo. She was always there an hour before to get her seat, get her cards, get comfortable. And I'm thinking, oh my God, and then you sit. I like going at the very last minute. Go at the very last minute. Sit down, put in your cards in the machine, get your pop, whatever you want, sit down and play. That's what I like to do. But anyway. Anyway, I just kind of phased out there for a while. What else? It's going to be a long video, because I think I did 3 sections of this thing. I think. Yeah, oh gosh, I got to pick up Mom's pills at the pharmacy too. We won't do that now, we'll do it after. We'll pick those up. Mom's really getting forgetful. But that's okay, you know. I'm trying really, really hard to be sweet when I talk to her, so even if I have to repeat myself, I like to keep speaking to her softly so that she doesn't feel like I'm treating her like a child. Let's face it, nobody likes it. I know I'd be cranky as hell, no matter, you know, even though my memory was good, I would be a cranky old woman because I don't like people telling me what to do. So I gotta put myself in their place, right? So I'm headed home to pick up Mom, then we're gonna head back. Oh my goodness. Sorry guys, I was tired. That was a good session. I really enjoyed working with those ladies. There's always one, lady that works. She's really nice, but oh my God, she's always like $10, $12 short. Like that's, you know, if you're selling a card for $1 or $2 each, a card, and you have a stack of cards which you've counted in the beginning and you know how much money you have in it, you know, how can you be short $8? Like, I can understand 2, 3, 4. Sometimes even I'll stretch it to say 5. Stretching it, that's really bad. But $1, $2, $3, it happens, you know. Sometimes you give the wrong change, but I always count it out. Or sometimes, you know, you drop a loony, or like today with me, paying that lady, the lady gave me $2 for one of the cards, and it flipped and went flying, and I don't know where it went. I thought it went in my pocket, but I think it went on the floor somewhere. And let's face it, if you're walking down the aisle and you see a toonie and there's nobody around, you're gonna put it in your pocket. Anyway, guys, gray day in Ottawa. Gray day in Ottawa. Coolish. I don't have my winter coat on today. I've got a light jacket on. I was talking so much to everybody that I got a dry tickle in my throat. I think it's, you know, whatever. So, Bonnie, one of my friends from Bingo that passed away, her sister-in-law dropped off her obituary for me, which I thought was really sweet. Her funeral's on Saturday. We'll be going. I gotta bring a lot of Kleenex because I know I'll be tearing up. She's always, I remember, her laugh was awesome. She's up in heaven right now with another gentleman in the car beside me. He was just at the bingo. He was playing. Anyway, guys, I'm going to let you go, and hopefully I will be seeing you guys real soon. Thanks for sticking around, even though I'm not doing crafts and stuff, and at least not right now, but thanks for sticking by me and checking in on me when I put up these crazy videos. I really would prefer to do a nice cute daily vlog. I just, you know, it's with, now that I have Mom with me, I just find it's really, really difficult to do videos. I don't know if it's because I feel self-conscious or whether I should just do it anyway, and when she interrupts, just tell her what I'm doing. I don't know. I was going to take you along on my moving trip, but that didn't pan out the way I wanted it to. But that's okay. You know what? Life's full of challenges and changes, and, you know, you do what you got to do. Mom doesn't understand it. Poor Mom. I love her to death, but, you know, she's not used to moving. I'm used to just, you know, whatever, pack up and go. The stress is usually the moving day that to me is stressful, because sometimes you can't get your keys early, and sometimes you have to spend the night somewhere else or wait until midnight to move in because your lease is up on the end of the month and your other new lease starts on the first of the month and blah 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 blah. Anyway, I'm home. We'll talk to you soon. Thanks for joining us. Bye for now.